I think that's going to be the goal too, man. Mm-hmm. I think that's what's going to happen. Yeah. Can I bring up one point that I hadn't heard anybody on ESPN, Fox Sports say? Philadelphia coach got fired. Does he bench the white quarterback and started the black quarterback? That's just point blank. Let's not beat around this bush anymore. I'm sick and tired of the owner called, because you had your exit interview. He had his exit interview. He called him back off vacation. Talked to him because he said he was hearing speculation that Wentz was not going to start. And he said, no, I can't definitely tell you Wentz is going to start. We may go in another direction. They met that day. He said, let's meet again in the morning. I need for you to come back and tell me Wentz is going to start. No, I can't. It was two things. Wentz starting, and he wanted to fire some of his assistant coaches because he blamed everybody except for Wentz. Everybody except for Wentz. If you are a coach and you're promoting a quarterback that looks like us and you get fired, how many coaches you think gonna keep doing that? None. Well,
Mo, it's on your face. I want to hear Mo.
No, that's a good point, but I will say, and I stick to what I said earlier, it's more than just race in these situations, because in today's NFL, you got to think about it. You use the example of Philadelphia. There's a white quarterback and a black quarterback. But you look around the league, I don't know the numbers of how many black starting quarterbacks there are, but a lot of them are doing well. And let's use Patrick Mahomes, for example. It's a contract situation with him. If he started to stink, if Patrick Mahomes just, for whatever reason, was not playing well, they're going to keep trotting out Patrick Mahomes because of his contract, not because of his skin color. So I see what you're saying in Philadelphia.
So that's a GM. That's a GM move, right?
It's a GM move. It's an owner move. But whoever it may be, because of his contract and because of him being the franchise player, he will get a lot more leeway, a longer leash, than a guy who is maybe a rookie or second-year player who is not getting paid that much. And the team is not necessarily as deep financially in on him. That's just the way that happens. I don't think that's necessarily it's always a race thing from that perspective. And let me say this last point too. And I go back to the point I made earlier about guys looking out for guys, right? And a lot of times what we see on the outside is Isaac said, they all kind of look like Tom Hanks. But the point is, there's guys looking out for guys, and it does not discredit the guy who might not be proven. It does not mean that he might not do a good job. We see a lot of coaches, if you look at the Detroit Lions, if you look at the New York Jets, when Adam Gase had his press conference a couple of years, look at a lot of these guys, when they're introduced, a lot of us think the same thing. This guy might not make it, right? But somebody vouched for them, and somebody believed in them. I'm not asking people to stop vouching for and stop believing in their guys. But what I am asking is for somebody to start vouching for and start believing in black coaches the same way that they do it for white coaches. So in your example, the Philadelphia coach lost his job because he benched the white guy for the black guy. But the way I see it is, the Philadelphia coach benched the franchise guy for the unproven guy.